All right, less than 48 hours out. Let's have some real talk about this game. Texas this year, they're good. They're very good. I'll give credit where credit's due. It's not often Texas walks into this game undefeated anymore. They're 5-0. Did they mess around with Rice in the first half, week one? Yeah, then they flipped a switch in the second half. Did they mess around with Wyoming a little bit in the first half, all the way to the fourth quarter? Yeah, then they flipped a switch and took over the game. They are not the same weak-ass Texas team. They've got guys in the middle of their D-line that are legit. Pass catchers are legit. Quinn Ewers is playing some of his best football. Now, on the flip side of that, Oklahoma. Bad news, running the football, it's not something we've been doing well this year. We have not run the football effectively. We have got to find a way to get that fixed. I don't care who's out there. I don't care who carries the rock. The offensive line needs to play at their best. They have got to figure this out. Because if they do not run the ball effectively, we will lose this game. Now, the good news is that Dillon Gabriel playing his best football. Wide receivers, he doesn't have one guy that he needs to get the ball to. He has 8 or 9 different guys he can throw the ball to. There's not one guy you can key in on. OU has like 8 or 9 guys that have like 10 catches or more this year. It's pretty insane. All that being said, Oklahoma, walking into this game, you knew. I told you all before the season, if they go 5-0, nobody's going to care. And honestly, you really shouldn't care because these are teams, Oklahoma should beat, you know, these teams. They should beat Arkansas State, SMU, Tulsa, Cincinnati, Iowa State. You're supposed to beat those teams. But, again, there are certain other programs that get more attention just because. I've been waiting for this game all offseason, not just because of what happened last year. You just want revenge for that, but we all knew what was going to happen. Was it going to be that bad or whatever? I didn't think that, but we knew we were going to lose the game. But what irritates me about the sports media, the college football side of things, you can tell the people who watch games and who don't. You can tell people who read box scores or just look at highlight reels. Now, is it possible to watch every single game on every weekend? No. But if you're going to do your homework, if you're actually going to talk about a team and talk about them intelligently, you should probably watch a little bit more than some highlights. But everyone who does that, they get... I keep hearing there's a talent gap at quarterback in this game. No. I've heard there's a talent gap with wide receivers. I disagree. Again... It irritates me because there are people who are compromised because they root for certain teams like a Michigan or a Texas, or, you know, they want a USC to be good or they want Ohio State to be good. There's certain programs that have either giant fan bases or certain media markets that add more clicks and add more revenue. And, you know, oh my God, a Michigan-Texas national title game would get a 20 rating. That's what it's about with some people. And you all know who I'm talking about. And guys, don't let the trolls, the obvious trolls, get to you. Don't let them poke. They like to poke the bear. They know they'll get a response. You all fall for it every time. You know who you are. For this team, you know, to be heard, like, I've heard all these things in the offseason too, or the past few weeks, because this week, for this game, a lot of people are forced to talk about Oklahoma because we're in the way of Texas and their big hero's journey to back to greatness, being back. That alone should motivate this team on Saturday to go kick some ass. I've heard this team called a paper tiger. I've heard them being called frauds. I've heard them called, you know, again, the talent gap is there. I've heard, well, you know, Brent Venables just doesn't sound right as a head coach. Like, you know how you fix all of that? You go kick ass on Saturday. You go win. It's just irritating to me. We've seen what Brent has done the past couple years. Recruiting has taken a whole new life. We're getting guys, or we're involved with certain guys that we had no chance under with Lincoln Riley. We're getting legit defensive players. People don't want to talk about that because it doesn't fit their narrative. So now, I need the leaders of this team. I need the upperclassmen. I need the Danny Stutzmans, the Drake Stoops, the Woody Washingtons. I need those guys to step up and lead this team. Because those guys know what it felt like last year to lose. A guy like Jane Gibson talked about, I've been thinking about this game for the past 2 weeks. So you hear other players say, yeah, you know, we need to go 1-0 this week. It's been on their minds. I think there's confidence with this team. I think they know they can go out there and win that game. Everyone else, you know, everyone thinks they know what's going to happen in this game every year. But we've been victim of this as well. We think, yeah, 2013, we'll beat Texas. We didn't. 2015, yeah, we'll beat Texas. We didn't. 2018, yeah, we'll beat Texas. We didn't. It's not guaranteed. This game can play with people. Can mess with people. So, a lot of people think Texas is the most complete team in the country. Some think they're number one. That alone, spread's like 6.5, 6, last I checked. Maybe I'll get down to the devil's number, 5.5. Everyone loves 5.5, all you gamblers out there. OU needs this game. OU needs this game bad. This is the only big game on the schedule, folks. All due respect to Bedlam, no. They suck this year. TCU, BYU, West Virginia might be a sneaky big game if they keep... No. This is the game. If they go out there and lose, is it the end of the program as we know? No. It just means you have to take one step back and go back to the drawing board and pray you make it to Arlington. Because then all of a sudden, because that's the only way you can salvage the season. No one wants to go play in the Alamo Bowl or the Cheez-It Bowl or whatever bowl games. You want to play in something that matters. And to get there, you have to win this game. But the thing is, I don't care. People talk about whoever wins is going to be in a college football playoff conference. Let me tell you something right now. As a fan, I don't give two shits about the playoff right now. I care about beating Texas. OU needs this game. Texas, they have the Alabama win in their back pocket. They lose, they can still bounce back and get back to the Big 12 championship and they can try to win. OU needs this one. Force people to talk about you in a positive light. Force people to eat their words. Force people to look stupid by going out on Saturday and getting the job done. X factors for this game. On offense, Nick Anderson. Every other time he touches the football, he's in the end zone. Jaden Gibson. It's time for him to make some big plays and big catches. We've seen what he can do. He can out-muscle some people. Defensive side of the football, Peyton Bowen. It's time. It's time to show the world who you are. You've been playing like a five-star this year. Show it to the world on a national stage. PJ Odubarawe, it's time to unleash the beast. I'm certain there are many more people. I expect Danny Stutzman to have a great game. I expect these guys to do their thing. It will be a war. There will be no blowouts either way. This is going to be a fight to the bitter end. Whatever happens, happens. But I want to see this team play with their... Fight their... You know, bring their guts. Like, bring everything they got. Fight tooth and nail to win this one. Because win or lose, I'll be proud of this football team. If they can do that. So, that being said, I'm getting on a plane tomorrow to go to Dallas. And I'll see you all at the fair. If you happen to see me, I'll be wearing a red hat, red shirt, and jeans. I'm sure I'll stick out like a sore thumb. So, Boomer Sooner. If you happen to be going to the game, I'll see y'all in Section 27. Boomer.